Well, like the other race, second time's a charm. I already done this race once before, but and it may make it to YouTube depending how this one also goes. But that one ended up with me getting
Effect is
wrecked.
clear. Okay, Corey,
No
you've gone to
yellow.
two laps. Let's get this done.
And then the whole video was just me proceeding. Was just me proceeding to be pissed off and ranting that throughout the entire video. So, figured I would have a second go. Figure I would have a second go at this. And plus, the incident itself wasn't really that bad. I ended up actually having a 10x that race, but in all honesty, I mean, I got lucky with a car phasing through me and giving me a 4x. So, like, say, let's just say that didn't happen with that car phasing through me getting a 4x. I still would have had a 6x altogether. Let off the brake a little bit too soon. That was terrible.
V6, that one was at 27.3.
So we ended up getting a time for P5.
Speed limit in the pits. Box in 1630 feet.
Excuse me. Should I mute on my mic? I tried to, but all right. So
box in 5.
Seems like we have
4,
some pretty decent pace
3,
whenever
2,
we're pushing.
1. Box now. That's the end of the session. P5.
See, what was the pole time? 55.9. So about 4 tenths. But considering everyone's pretty close to each other. Alright. Just scoot up a little bit. Oops. Alright, let's hope we don't get caught up in other people's shenanigans. It's a 50 lap race, it's gonna be a long one.
50 laps.
We are definitely gonna have to pit.
Follow car number 16.
At some point during the race. Lane. Also, depending on how many yellows we get. We only got one yellow last race that I ran. Or. That was, you know, that I ran and recorded. And kind of raised a little bit too much for my liking. Yeah, a little bit of hair. How my... Yeah. There we go. Alright. Let's get this race started and hopefully we actually have a good result.
Glory, green, green, green.
Wow, we almost ran it back into fucking 16.
Still there.
Shifted a little bit.
Still there.
Too early there, but
keep your line. Clear on the outside.
Let's just take it easy.
Now leading.
I wonder what caused that yellow.
This car is out. Line up single file behind car number 15.
I wonder what happened behind us to constitute that yellow. I really need to investigate after the race.
Under caution, pits are closed. Pits are open.
I must say, I keep on forgetting just how big Pocono actually is. Not only how wide it is, but just how fucking long it is. It's like, it's not as... it's not as long as Daytona, I do believe. But it feels longer because of how you have to slow down for the corners as much as you do and everything. But at the same time, it's deceptively fast because of this. Well, I don't know. I have a love and hate relationship with Pocono. Because, as a kid, on the games and stuff, Pocono was one of those tracks that I could never understand. And, just because of the unique nature of the track, my young brain couldn't wrap my mind around it. And even now, it's still a little... The tunnel turn is a little... it still gets me. Or turn two, as some might say. Mainly because I didn't understand the concept of lifting off for a current for a corner back then. Sim racing has taught me a lot. Gonna be on the outside, right? Yeah.
Get ready. Race will resume at the end of this lap.
What is going on with that car? He wasn't a lap down though. I have no idea what the 17 was doing. You know, I'm forgetting off the top of my head if the start line thing is enabled, or the restart zone is enabled. I don't think it is. I'm pretty sure it isn't. I'm like 75% sure it isn't.
File behind car 09.
Yeah, that's interesting. Something must have went on behind.
Are open. Car is out, pits are closed.
All right, so this is already more cautions than what was in our last race, but I wonder if that has to do with the people behind or with, you know, the people that's currently in the race. Either way, I'm glad I'm, you know, up in front here and not back behind there.
Okay, Corey, get ready. Race will resume at the end of this lap.
Alright. One to go. We're still doing all right. Granted, there was two cautions back to back, with both of the racks happening behind us. So let's just hope that all the wrecks keep on happening behind us. Alright, let's ease it onto the throttle this time.
Green flag, we're racing. Sixth place.
New fastest lap for Brooke. Follow. Still there, clear low.
Alright, not the best start, but
57.9, seventh position. That lap time was 59.3. Fastest lap for Brunk, 56.8.
But we can still capitalize.
New crew is leading the race.
Oh, yeah, probably not like that. I don't understand how these people are faster than me.
Oh, they're 56.5. The gap in front is now 1.48.
You see, this is the exact reason why I get pissed off whenever I have, like, fucking, like, number one I rating, or, like, the number one I rating in the split. It's because, like, I have to finish within the top five, or some bullshit get like there. That. Or else I will lose iRating.
Keep your line. Clear on the inside. Oh no, stay high. Hold your line. Clear down low.
That was almost resulted in a crash. My god! Like, I don't know if I or I've already overcooked my tires or what's going on. Or if I just am or if I just don't have any talent. I mean, I guess if I want to improve my I rating and stuff, there are going to be some splits where I am, you know, number one, you know, the number one driver and everything. But it's just with how I rating works and everything, it almost punishes you for driving safely. Because if you do and you finish in the back, guess where you're going to end up? Lower down with all the fucking idiots. I don't know. That's just what I've noticed. I broke Woat way too soon for that corner. I misjudged the brake. I thought the brake marker was the wrong one. Okay, good. Okay, yeah, see, that's weird. That is so weird how that didn't give me a 2X, but I hit pretty much the exact same ball in the exact same place, like last race. Oh, shit. And it gave me a 2X.
V12s.
Nelly. I wonder if everyone's just lifting off for that for the tunnel turn and not braking like I am.
caution, be careful.
Interesting. Okay, so I'm pretty sure all the cautions that have been called this race has happened in the front stretch. So yeah. Alright, so we're not exactly in the pit window.
Closed.
But
full course yellow, pits are open.
We're still gonna pit. I think it's gonna be pretty stupid for us not to pit.
The leader, Altneri, is pitting. Speed limit. Pit lane speed limit is 60 miles per hour. We'll need to stop again. Box in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
We had damage? From what? I'm genuinely trying to think what if we got any type of damage from something. Seventeen must have gotten a black flag coming out of the pits.
Are open.
As of right now, we shall only take right sides if there's another yellow in the middle of the race type thing. If it's like happens like say at like around 30, a lap around 30 or so. But if it's like, say, a lap around 40, then...
We're going green next time by.
Then we would take all four tires or something. So, once we go to green, we will be coming up on halfway. Soonish. After green. Alright, let's get back to racing.
Green flag.
All wheels up. Still there,
the end.
Still with the other.
Smith, just lifted the right side.
Shit, I honestly didn't expect him to die down like that. If I would have known, I wouldn't have turned down like I did.
It's car low. Inside's clear.
Yep, got a little bit loose. Wanted to make sure. Oh god.
Car low. Still there. Side's clear.
These cold tires are a little something. Gotta make sure I don't like overspin them like that, or else I'll kill them. Or heat them up. Again, I misjudged the brake marker.
Gap 2, track behind us now, 1.6.
Everyone's having kind of a really tough time on these new tires, it looks like. I went way too low. because, yeah, the car just bounces way too much on the transitions and stuff, especially because the bottom's real bumpy.
Oh, on the low side. He's still there. Still there. Still there. Clear inside.
Alright.
Smith is now in the lead.
Well, I feel bad for that car because he's smacked into the wall pretty good. And there's going to be no yellow for him. And plus, that looked like he destroyed his engine. So, I'm pretty sure a caution wouldn't really do him any good. I really am bad at the tunnel turn. I seem to be really good at 1 and 3 though. Fairly decent enough. My God!
Alright, Corey, we're gaining on the car in front. The gap's now 0.9.
I barely touched the wall and it stuck to me like glue. He did the exact same thing I just did last lap. This will definitely bring us up to a position to where we can finish the race on not only on fuel, but I wonder if we should get all four tires. I'll say so. If there's anyone that just takes just two, they're gonna have a really difficult time with just two. Trust me, I know. I only took two last race, and that was a handful, so. Alright. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Come in, get off full tires, get enough fuel. I apparently have damage. Do I have any X's? No. The damage actually I have... Well, I believe I have some damage from hitting the wall earlier, but before that I can't quite remember what I got damage. Oh, hitting the wall from before. Okay, that's what it was.
Full yellow, pits are open.
Yeah, I whenever hit the wall and it didn't give me a 2x, that's actually good. It did give me some optional repairs, but yeah.
The leader, Smith, is pitting. Watch your speed. Okay, we'll fill you to the end. Box in 1490 feet. Box in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
Shit.
gates are open.
So, am I going to be on the inside or outside? With my luck, we're going to be on the outside. Yep.
Okay, Corey, get ready. Race will resume at the end of this lap.
Alright, so it's gonna be 15 to go. So far, this race is actually going pretty good. I know with me being the one car, I should be aiming for the top 5, but I'll be happy with the top 10. And I should be fast enough to get a top 10. Run into the back of 2, and I wanted to make sure my inside was actually clear.
Still there. Still with you. Still there. Clear on the outside.
Okay, Corey, the next car is trapped.
Not on the outside. Outside's clear.
Yeah, outside. I broke a little bit too much.
Outside's clear.
But I think that actually worked out in the end. Surprisingly.
P6. The gap to Fleming ahead is now 0.6.
Yeah, that was because I didn't put enough brake.
Still, yeah, clear line. Stay high. That's
good.
Stay high. Three wide, you're up high. Three down low.
P4. That last lap was at 57.7.
inside.
Ah, shit.
Clear on the inside.
It's like a happy medium between braking too much for the tunnel turn and not braking enough.
That's your fastest lap.
Come on! Kinda wish it was 5 to go and not 10 to go.
The gap to Fleming ahead is increasing. It's now 1.1 seconds.
Man, I'm gripping the wheel so tight, I need to relax, but it's everything's so intense right now, with me trying to get this P4. We're all good. We actually didn't lose too much time and all that, and me scraping the wall. Terrible turn. Terrible.
Gap 2, trap behind is now not protected.
Shit. I saw the wrong brake marker again. Just keep it together. My god, that tunnel turn really fucks you over if you get it wrong. Because it sets you up so bad for turn three. Because the car has been staying around the same. Or are you just saying that just to try to hurry me up? Or is it a different car that passed? To be fair, I'm not really paying all that much attention to who's exactly behind me. Okay, yeah, that was... It looks like he hit the wall. So, he's pushing all out. Whoop. Whenever I say that. I'm just gonna hold my line down here.
Oh, it's my line. The lap time was at 58.7.
Two more laps, Two may or may not pass us. We're definitely gonna fight for the position. But, I mean, if he, you know, if he gets under us in a, if he gets under us and whatnot in a corner and whatnot, we're not gonna fight too hard. Because at the end of the day, I just want to come home with zero X's and in the top five. But we are going to give him a good fight.
What was that? 57.8.
Actually have a chance here. And we hold on to fourth place.
Okay, that's the end. Good finish, mate. Well done.
That was a tough finish towards the end. Much better race and video than the first one that I recorded. So I am definitely gonna go with this one. Oh my goodness, I'm sweating after that race. And my hands are hurting because of how much, how hard I was gripping the wheel and stuff.
What's your speed limit in the pits? Box in 14, 190 feet. Box in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
Oh. Oh me. Don't usually do this, but since I actually have my last name and whatnot, Oh, I keep on forgetting that. Can I just say good win? Because holy shit, was that actually a good win? Yeah, look, I think that means a 6 second gap. Fucking hell. Let's quickly look at the... Let's quickly look at the, race, or the wrecks and stuff. Which, they should be a few. Oop, yeah. Got a little bit loose and, oop. So that would be the first yellow. Yeah, it was just a case of getting loose and smacking the car behind. Oh! Yeah, the checkup in the back is kind of real. Yeah, it's getting kind of late here. Dang. Wait, hold on. Did this actually cause a caution? I don't see any yellows. Oh, yeah, no, there is. Huh. Interesting. Wall hit. Sideways. Oh! Yeah, I bet that fucked the left side of the car up. Wall hit. Something happened for... Whoa. Yikes. That was definitely his fool's fault. Four's fault. Because he saw him in the mirror at the last split second, but Four he was drifting back onto his line slightly. Oh, is this? Yeah. Oh, yeah. I smacked the wall pretty good there. That's probably where that damage came from. Or at least that first bit of damage that I was wondering, where did it come from? When did I hit someone? Did someone hit me? Wait, hold on. So it's 19. Or 16? Oh, that's because he didn't hit a wall, okay, or anything like that. Oh. Yeah, that kind of killed the H's. Yeah, that's actually H's engine, or not actually. You get what I mean. His number is actually 8, and not actually no custom number. Ooh. Yeah, he hit the wall pretty good. Oop. Going too fast. Yeah. You'll do that in the tunnel turn. Looks like all of these are just gonna be wall hits. Because it's lap 31. Actually, there's gonna be one more yellow before the end of the night. Or before the... you get what I mean. Wait, hold on, what? Oh, what? What in the hell? Well, there's your problem. Okay, I remember seeing this. Yeah, this... what exactly caused this in the first place? So... 7's or 17's coming down. Or, oh no, 15 just straight up came up and bashed 17. Oh. Ever so slightly grazed the wall. Yeah, 2 hit the wall behind me, I seen that. 49. So him going over the wall must have triggered the yellow or something like that. Alright. Oops, no. I don't want to look at that one. I want to look at this one. Display, here we go. Alright. So, we gain 15 safety rating, getting it up there in the world, thankfully. And then we actually gained a good chunk of iRating, 48, which gets us closer to back to 1500, which that's what we want to see. Anyways, yeah. Whew, that was I don't want to say stressful race, but that was an exhausting race. I don't know if it was just because I've been sitting here trying to record for a couple hours now, but yeah. I feel better now that I got some good races done and dusted. But yeah, I guess that will be it for this video. Nice solid fourth place. Yeah, just all around good result, good everything. Hopefully this momentum will continue to roll on for the rest of the week, and we don't get run into again for a little bit. I know that's just iRacing, but it does get annoying after it happens over and over again. But yes, till next time, bye.